Dr. Peter Millett of the Steadman Clinic in Vail, Colorado has been consistently recognized as one of the world's best orthopedic surgeons. He joined us on the chairlift to talk about his passion for skiing and getting his patients back into the game. Today's SnowMotion chairlift interview is with Dr. Peter Millett. He's an orthopedic surgeon for the Steadman Clinic, specializing in elbow, shoulder, knee, well, actually, all sports medicine injuries. Peter, why did you come to Vail after being on the Harvard Medical School faculty?
Yeah, that's a great question. I love Vail. Look how beautiful it is here. And
good move.
It's a great place to live, and it's a great place to work. I've worked at some of the top places in the country, and I really feel that the level of care that's provided here, the quality of service, the quality of the orthopedics that's provided here is really the best there is. So the opportunity to join here, when that was presented to me, it was just perfect.
Peter, what surgeries do you do?
I do shoulder surgery, knee surgery, and some elbow surgery. So the most common things I do, rotator cuff surgery in the shoulder, which is a tear in the tendon, shoulder dislocations, shoulder separations, and then in the knee I do mainly ACL surgery and surgery on the cartilage, like the meniscus and cartilage injuries in the knee.
You're a consultant to all these sports teams. Can you tell us more about that?
I've treated athletes from the Olympics, from the ski team, from the NFL, NBA, Major League Baseball. We also integrate with rehab very, very tightly so that we don't just do the surgery, but we follow through on their rehabilitation, work closely with Howard Head Sports Medicine, and I think that really helps to improve our outcomes.
Do you have any personal story that you have been so satisfied that someone has come back after one of your surgeries?
Some of the more memorable ones are some of the, you know, just regular everyday people that we help, and I've had little old ladies come up and give me a hug that they couldn't raise their shoulders before we took care of them. And I remember everyone's story is special. Young kids that are ski racing that have Olympic dreams, to people that are, you know, weekend warriors, and then we have active older people. That's a great thing about this, the Vail Valley and this community, is we have people that are here in their 70s and 80s and they're counting how many powder days they got in, and they want to get out there and
that's gonna
just
be, us.
Be active.
That's gonna be us.
Yeah. So it's fun. It's fun to keep them going.
Yeah. No, we never want to stop. I love that about the Vail Valley, and also about our generation. I mean, the older generation too, that they want to be active and enjoy their lives to the fullest.
Yeah. Never grow old.
Never.
Yeah. Someone told me recently that if you have more dreams than achievements, you're still young. So. I still have a lot of dreams, so.
Me too. Even though I won't come back on the World Cup, though, that would be a little. Just talking now about the little kids in our valley, you are the medical director to the ski club Vail.
Oh, yes.
And so that's a nice volunteer position, which I'm sure takes some time.
Yeah, so about 2 years ago, we formalized a relationship with the Steadman Clinic to be the medical provider for Ski Club Vail. And Ski Club Vail is really a world-class organization. They have some of the top young athletes in snow sports, in ski racing, snowboarding, mogul skiing, and there's over 600 kids in the program. So they get injured and they needed some help with that. So it's been a great pleasure really to kind of give back a little bit and help the community in that way.
That's nice. And you are supplying a physical therapist when they do get injured, because again, the emphasis on the rehab after.
Yeah, we have a full-time physical therapist that works with the team. We've also implemented an injury surveillance program, so we're tracking any injuries that occur so that hopefully we can look at ways that we can prevent them. We're also implementing, we're calling it the SLIP program, but it's a snow sport lower injury prevention program to try and prevent people, you know, the young athletes from having injuries in the first place.
Ah, okay, what differentiates the Steadman Clinic from other clinics around the U.S. or the world?
I think that one of the things that differentiates us is really just the quality of the care that's provided, the attention to detail, the level of surgery that's done, the integration with rehab, and then we validate all of our outcomes with our research. We track every single patient. So I know in my own patients how they're gonna do. So I can tell patients what their percentage chance of getting back to sports, getting back to, you know, pain-free lifestyle, whatever. And I know in my own patients what that is. And I think that makes a big difference. because then I can continue to try and push the limits and get people better faster, more quickly, and back to levels that are, you know, essentially back to normal. And the new thing that we're really excited about is regenerative medicine, using the body's own natural healing mechanisms with stem cells and growth factors to try and enhance healing and really speed up people's recoveries. A lot of people don't know that, but some of the research that comes out of here is really innovative, groundbreaking, and really impacts people from around the world.
And the new BioMotion lab too can give you that feedback.
Yeah, we're really excited about our new BioMotion lab. It allows us to look at patients before surgery while they're injured and see how their movement patterns have changed. We can compare that to normal, healthy people, but we can also then hopefully fix their problem and then see how closely we restored it back to normal. And then try and, you know, see perhaps when they're ready to go back to elite levels of competition, or just, you know, weekend warriors when they can get back out and play tennis or golf or go skiing.
You're a father of four. You're a consultant to all these national sports teams. Where do you find the most joy?
I think that my family probably gives me the most joy of anything. I mean, I have four great kids and a wonderful wife, and I'm really, you know, just blessed by that. I love what I do. I have a really rewarding job. It's very satisfying. It's very, you see the results. It's tangible. You help people get back to what they love doing. They, you know, bring us photos of themselves doing, you know, kite surfing or playing football or playing the piano, whatever it is. And it's just, it's so great to be able to help people get back to their passions.
Good. Well, I mean, it's nice to have you, because it sounds like you fix people fast and get them back on, you know, whatever they're doing.
Yeah, well, some of the athletes' time of recovery is really important. You know, they have a season coming up, and they can't
Olympics,
miss it.
You know,
yeah, the Olympics. They have to be ready for that. You know, even with high school athletes, sometimes if they're in a certain part of the season, if they miss that season, they miss their opportunity to perhaps get looked at for college. So timing with sports medicine, timing of return to play is really something we work on and try and get people back as quickly as we can.
So you're doing a lot of teaching. Tell us about your teaching.
Yeah, we have a fellowship program, which is kind of the last year of your training. We bring orthopedic surgeons in that spend a year with us. And they work directly with us in sort of a tutelage type of program, almost like an apprenticeship. And then they go out and kind of become ambassadors for what we're doing. We have 6 or 7 U.S. fellows every year, plus we have a number of international fellows. So really, we're having a global reach with what we do. And we benefit as well, because they bring their ideas to us. They're young, they have a lot of enthusiasm, and we share our knowledge with them, and then they kind of bring it to their community. So it really spreads the word.
Okay, well, what a treat to have you on SnowMotion.
Ah, thanks, Brenda. It's great to be here.
You're welcome. Okay, we're going to ski down. Thanks for watching.
And it's a nice powder day here, too.